things are yin or yang, created from two essences. The world of men is ruled by the mandate of heaven's will. When the mandate is absent, kingdoms collapse and a turbulent age begins. Calming this disharmony is the mission of the one who is chosen by the mandate. The sun is setting on the Han Empire, which has reveled in 400 years of prosperity. Throughout the land, catastrophes abound. Rebellions multiply. The divine rule falls. Thus begins the turbulent age of rival warlords. The child emperor, lacking both the power and the experience to manage royal affairs, entrusts the imperial seal, the symbol of the mandate, to one woman. Fate now calls forth a new hero.
The lord of a small province, in whose heart no evil dwells. He is my love.
My lord, I am at your service.
You saved us.
You have my gratitude.
This is Kaukau. Disciplined and decisive. Once an officer of the Empire, he raised a personal army in search of world domination. After the battle, Liu Bei throws a banquet to honor Kaukau for having saved his life.
We would have died without your help, my friend. Diao Chan. Truly, all I want to do is live in peace. Live with you, Diao Chan.
True love, how very sweet.
Hey, bring more drinks for Lord Kaukau.
Drink up, my friend.
Liu Bei. Indifferent to world domination, Kaukau thinks of nothing else. A fragile truce between two men who could never really be friends. Their brief encounter foretold the tragedy to come.
Heaven is beyond grasp. The woman of destiny brings ruin.
Commanded by the priestess, I also witnessed Kaukau's oracle. When I heard its pronouncement, I shook with fear, for I felt that what I saw before was confirmed. A secret I could not even tell Liu Bei. Only months later, Kaukau threw in his lot with the priestess and took up arms against us. To kidnap me. No, to kidnap the secret I held so close.
Let her go! Liu Chen!
me, Mei. Mei! Brother!
Liu Bei!
Diao-chan!
I was taken. Liu Bei barely escaped the capital with his life. Others were not so fortunate. There was a rainbow that day as well. Yes, that was the root of it all. The long, drawn-out war between two arch-rivals, Liu Bei and Cao Cao.
After Cao Cao's sudden attack and kidnapping of Diao Chan from the capital, Liu Bei is narrowly able to escape to his own land of Zhu. Cao Cao, sensing the opportunity to seize the Zhu province, orders his vassal, the fierce general Jiahao Yuan, to attack. Jiahao Yuan's army approaches, yet Liu Bei has not yet decided whether he will engage in war with Cao Cao.
Brother! Cao Cao's forces are getting too close to us! Come on, let's attack them first!
The envoy we sent to Cao Cao was murdered in cold blood. Why in the world should we wait?
Cao Cao, why did you betray me? Why are you attacking? Didn't we break bread and drink to friendship?
Brother! Don't you want to rescue Diao Chan? We can't let this Cao Cao get away with this!
I'm going! I only live to take revenge for Mei Mei!
Don't you know how many good men have died to get you this far? When will you start fighting back?
Brother, I can see my words won't convince you. If you're still in doubt, ask them!
Listen! I have one desire. Diao Chan! We must fight a battle to save her! And there will not be a single night's peace until we have won the war! Knowing what that means, what awaits you? Do you still want Liu Bei to lead you into battle? I say give it our all!
I do want to save Diao Chan!
Lord Liu Bei, we will fight for you!
And now?
A war. I will meet Cao Cao.
It is done. Let the battle begin!
More soldiers have deserted?
They're panicked by the enemy, sir. I don't know how to say it. It's more and more each day.
Oh, that Cao Cao. What a coward.
So then, is there no one who will fight against me here?
I'll never fight without a reason.
Then tak kalai tu sinta, then tak kalai tu sinta.